millions of Iranian people have sought to raise legitimate concerns about the 2009 electoral process and to exercise their universal rights. The government of Iran has suppressed their protests, often resulting in violence. The United States strongly condemns the recent violence and the unjust suppression of innocent Iranian citizens. Allow UN Special Rapporteur on Torture to visit the country and provide him with access to detention facilities. And finally, allow for a visit by the Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights and by other UN Special Rapporteurs and experts who have requested access to Iran.
Quote, Iran's stated commitment to safeguard universal principles of human rights, including fundamental freedoms, non-discrimination, fair trial, and equality before the law. Despite these commitments, grave human rights violations continue to be committed, and we underline the requirement for Iran to abide by its international and constitutional human rights obligations. We also highlight serious concerns about the rights of detainees to free and fair trials, one, that Iran facilitates visits by all special procedure mandate holders outstanding since 2005, and issues an invitation to the UN Secretary General so that he may investigate the post-election violence and independently assess the human rights situation.
Germany remains deeply concerned about the way the Islamic Republic is dealing with those who took part in the peaceful protests after the 2009 presidential elections. Germany would like to know why the citizens of the Islamic Republic are being hampered from having a peaceful and open dialogue about the future development of their country. Germany recommends Iran to allow freedom of expression, freedom of the media, and of assembly, to immediately stop executions and abolish the death penalty.
Monsieur le Président, la France est profondément inquiète de la situation des droits de l'homme en Iran. Cette situation s'est gravement détériorée durant les huit derniers mois. Les autorités se livrent à une répression sanglante contre leur propre population qui revendique pacifiquement ses droits. Depuis l'élection présidentielle du 12 juin 2009, des dizaines de personnes ont été tuées, des milliers d'autres ont été emprisonnées, des actes de torture et de viol ont été rapportés.
Thank you, Mr. President. Canada takes note of Iran's presentation. Nevertheless, Canada is seriously concerned with the continued deterioration of the human rights situation in Iran and violent crackdowns by security forces on its citizens, especially since the June 2009 presidential elections. Contrary to Iran's constitution, peaceful public demonstrations have been met with widespread repression, including arbitrary arrest and detention without due process, ill treatment and torture. Deaths in custody and severe restrictions on freedoms of expression, assembly, and association. Canada recommends that Iran release or charge and bring before a court in a manner consistent with international fair trial standards. Canada recommends that Iran amend its Islamic Penal Code law on offenses against national and international security of the country to
indicate a high number of cases of illegal arrests, incommunicado detention, torture, rape, and even murder by security officials and paramilitary militias, in particular in the aftermath of the presidential elections. We call for the immediate end of such serious violations.
Denmark is seriously concerned about the violent crackdowns on demonstrators and opposition figures by the Iranian authorities since the June 2009 presidential election. A report by Human Rights Watch released this month points to extrajudicial killings, rapes, torture, violations of the rights to freedom of assembly and expression, as well as thousands of arbitrary arrests as part of a governmental run intimidation campaign. Furthermore, several arrested persons have been put on trial accused of Muharreb carrying the death penalty. Denmark recommends that the Iranian government takes timely and extensive measures to guarantee its citizens the right to express dissent.
We would like to concentrate on three important areas of concern. First, Italy is seriously concerned at the systematic use of capital punishment in Iran, especially against juvenile offenders.
Monsieur le Président, la dégradation en général de la situation des droits de l'homme en Iran suscite l'inquiétude du Luxembourg, situation notamment marquée par des restrictions de plus en plus sévères sur la liberté d'expression et d'information, la multiplication des condamnations à la peine de mort, y compris à l'encontre de mineurs, la condamnation à des traitements inhumains et dégradants comme la flagellation et l'amputation, le harcèlement et la répression des défenseurs des droits de l'homme, l'intensification de la répression des militants pour les droits des femmes.
Mr. President, this review takes place at a time when there is the very deepest concern at the human rights situation in Iran. Violations of basic human rights are taking place, including freedom of expression, association and assembly, and the use of torture and the death penalty.
Mr. President, Spain would like to express its concern over...
Gracias, señor presidente. España desea expresar su preocupación por el continuo deterioro de la situación de los derechos humanos en Irán. Recomendamos al gobierno de Irán que acepte de forma inmediata las solicitudes de visita de los procedimientos especiales para que éstas se realicen en el más breve plazo de tiempo.
The Netherlands is gravely concerned about reports after the presidential elections on extrajudicial and arbitrary detention, suspects being held without being informed about their charges, the absence of due process and the possible use of torture and other cruel, inhumane and degrading treatment or punishment.
La Belgique recommande au gouvernement irakien de veiller à ce que toutes les exactions à l'encontre des minorités ethniques, linguistiques ou religieuses soient dûment investiguées et poursuivies, y compris dans le contexte de l'examen de la situation des résidents du camp Ashraf. Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
We welcome Iraq's assurances that the human rights of Camp Ashraf inhabitants will be upheld and residents will not be forcibly repatriated to Iran.